Good day, this is Prophetess Wendy. Thank you so much for joining me. If you're joining us for the first time, I'd like to welcome you. And to my subscribers, I'd like to thank you so much. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, you're more than welcome to do so. This is the true prophet of the Lord. I only speak through the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Today, I'm so excited because I'm speaking to my friends, I'm speaking to family, I'm speaking to the mother pastors. Hallelujah. New or old, hallelujah. We can only listen to what the Spirit has to say to you today. The Bible says in the book of Revelation, listen to what the Spirit has to say to you. So the question being, what are the most important things that you should know as a mother pastor? I'm here to share all the information. I'm not going to hide. But today, this is going to be part two. We have already dealt with part one. So part two, trust me, it's more interesting. Hallelujah. I cannot say more than the other. That will depend, hallelujah, on how you see everything. But I believe through the guidance of the Holy Spirit, you're going to learn a lot today. I will start by saying that another thing that I found to be very interesting in my journey as a mother pastor, this is very, very important for you to know. Hallelujah. I will say that you need to know the word of God. Hallelujah. You need to know the word of God. You know, the Bible says in the book of Joshua 1 verse 8, this book of the law must not depart from your lips. You must meditate upon it day and night so that you can be successful and prosperous in your way. This was God speaking to Joshua after the death of Moses. So what am I saying? Before you can lead any congregation, you as a mother pastor, I know that you are born again. I know that you are a Christian. You know the Lord. But it's always important for you to know the word of God. Don't just read the word of God when you're going to attend a prayer meeting or when they've requested you to preach the gospel. You have to study the word of God for the sake of your own growth. What is the benefit of studying the word of God? The word of God has got everything. The same way we buy magazines, I love reading different types of books. The same way we read books, you know, we get information and everything else that we love that is interesting. The same goes for the Bible. If you are going to call yourself a mother pastor, you need to be filled with the word of God. The word of God helps you on how to treat other people. Because when you're reading, the Bible says this book of the law must not depart from your lips. When you don't have the word of God, you're most likely to hurt people in the church. You're most likely to speak your mind, to share peace of your mind. And you know, sometimes when we share peace of our mind, we are most likely to mislead others if you are not careful. So it's always good when you speak to church members, you refer them to the Holy Scriptures. You give them knowledge. You give them wisdom. The Bible says my people are dying because of lack of knowledge. You know, when they say somebody lacks wisdom, it's somebody that does not study the Scriptures. Because the book of James says, if anybody lacks the wisdom, let them come and ask from me. The Bible teaches you on how to treat people. You know, I was reading a certain scripture that says that when we've got visitors, we've got special place for them. I've learned that from the Bible, that I need to have special plates for my guests. Why? Because that is what is required by the Bible. Another thing, the Bible will teach you on how to dress. It will teach you that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, meaning that even the way I conduct myself in the church of God, it cannot be the same as when I'm at home. Amen. At home, I can wear whatever that I want. It doesn't matter that nobody's looking at me. It's me with my kids. It's me with my husband. A mother pastor needs to look nice for his own family. But God says, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Meaning, whenever you go to church, you must know how to dress as a mother pastor. There are mother pastors who sometimes dress. You find that the congregation is even afraid to look at you as a mother pastor. You find that you are out of order. It's possible to be a mother pastor, but being out of order. You find that the way you dress, people cannot even look at you. Why? Because the way you are dressing is not appropriate. But when you study the Holy Scriptures, it will teach you on how to dress. And God does not specify to say long dresses every Sunday. No, every woman has got her own style on how she wants to dress. With me, they call me a fashionist. They say that I like putting on different wear, different clothes, you know, I'm one person who is not afraid to try something new. I'm one person that is creative to come up with my own style, with my own fashion. But one thing that I love for sure, when you go to church, make sure that you cover up, but dress nicely, not like Magogo, not like an old person. You know, you at the church, you represent God, you represent the Holy Spirit. But that has nothing to do with what we are talking about today. But I just wanted to teach you that when you know the Holy Scriptures, you also know how to conduct yourself. The Bible also teaches you that you must never show favoritism as a mother pastor. You learn that from the Holy Scriptures. When you read the Word of God, it will teach you on how to treat people. It says that when somebody comes into the prayer meeting or into the church because they are dressing nice, you find that there is a poor person who's sitting in front. You go and take that poor person in front, you take them to the back, then you put this rich one. The Bible says you'll offend that poor member. Hallelujah. You'll offend the poor member. It meaning why you need to love people equally. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter rich or poor. You as a mother pastor has got the responsibility to love. But if you are not studying the Holy Scriptures, how will you know such type of information? The Bible will also teach you, will speak of submission. You know, you learn from people like Moses who had their own congregation. You learn from Deborah. You know, you learn from Rebecca. You learn from Sarah. You learn from Hagar. There are different type of women who are written in the Bible for us to learn. You begin to learn their character. You begin to learn how they conducted themselves with their husband. How were they respecting their husband and so forth. You as a mother pastor need to know the Holy Scriptures. Can you imagine a pastor standing in front of the church and then now they are looking for the book of Jude? You as a mother pastor carrying the Bible, you don't even know where Jude is. No, sometimes sit down, get to study the Holy Scriptures to say Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers. You know, get to know the Bible. You know, sometimes you know every soapy, you know 7 o'clock, it's going to be this, 8 o'clock is gonna be that, 9 o'clock is gonna be this. The same goes for the Word of God. You need to know, okay, the first book in the Bible is the book of Genesis, the last book is the book of Revelation. The Bible is a big book. You might not be able to finish the whole book, but give it your responsibility, make it your responsibility to tell yourself, you know what, this January, I'm going to study the book of Genesis, you know, and then you study the whole book of Genesis. Then you go to Exodus. Sometimes start with the New Testament. People cannot just come and stand in the church. You are a mother pastor. You are there. People will come and ask you scriptures. You know, sometimes my daughter comes and asks me about a particular scripture, about particular people in the Bible. You find that you don't even know anything as a mother pastor. No, you need to know the Word of God. You need to be helpful to the Christian in the church. People trust you. You as a mother pastor must be the walking and talking Bible, spirit filled. Why? Because the Bible gives you wisdom as a woman. It gives you wisdom as a woman because it teaches you a lot of things, how to conduct yourself, how to respond. You know, sometimes you don't even know how to react when people gossip about you, but the Bible will teach you there on how to respond, and it will teach you don't gossip, because even birds can take news and go and tell the other person. Where do I learn this? I learned this from the Bible. Even resolving issues, the Bible will teach you on how to resolve issues. There are so many things that I can say about the Bible. I read the Bible. You know, the one thing that I love about the Bible, when you read it, every chapter, you can repeat it 10 times, 15,000 times. You'll always get a new revelation. There are times when I open up and then I see, oh, it's just names. Oh, it's just what. Oh, they're just speaking about who and who. There are times when I open a chapter and I don't even understand why. But I still read it. Why? Because it's important. Even though I might be reading that today, and then you find that 10 years later, when I'm standing, I still remember the Holy Spirit reminds me of what I've read 10 years back. So what am I saying? The Word is good for you. A person that is filled with the Word of God is not one person that can easily offend people. It's not one person that is going to hurt other people in the church. Why? Because you are filled with the Word of God. You've got knowledge. You've got knowledge. A person filled with knowledge is a wise woman. You know, don't be empty and empty-headed as a mother pastor. Not the word of God, not the Holy Scriptures, you know. It will even teach you on how to conduct yourself towards the men of God because it speaks of submission. But if you don't read the Bible, you'll never understand. You find that you are even failing to submit under the men of God because you don't have the word of God in you. So what am I saying? Most of the things, people always call me a wise woman. People call me a true prophet. Why? Because I only speak the word of God. There's a time when I don't quote straight to say, this is Gabriel, this is Mary, this is Martha. No, from the Bible, I just give them an example. There was once a certain woman, because people don't understand things the same. There are people that need example from the Bible. There are times when people will come with a hard, serious situation where they need you to speak the word. But if you don't have it in you, you'll end up speaking your things. You'll end up speaking things and missing things. It's easy for God to work with someone that has got the word. The word is like when you go to driving school, they give you that manual to study. You know, when you don't study that manual, how will you know the signs? How will you know how to drive a car on the road? You know, sometimes you feel like, ah, it's not important. The book is not important. No, the book is there so that you can know the road signs. Even the Bible is good for you to know what God wants. If there's one thing that moves God, it is His word, you know. Everything that we do, we have to take the word of God as it is. It says success comes from us knowing the word of God, because when you are studying the Holy Scriptures there, it will teach you that God hates a lazy person. It will teach you that I have to pray in order for me to grow as a mother pastor. Can I say I'm a mother pastor of the church, so therefore I cannot pray, everything must just fall into place? No, the moment I'm there, it means what? I have to pray more. Why? Because the Bible will be teaching me that Jesus Christ will go to a solitary place to pray on His own. You know, as a woman, how do I conduct myself? You know, a lot of things. There are a lot of beautiful things that I've learned, even table manners. You know, the Bible teach you a lot of beautiful things that I've learned from the Bible. So what am I saying? As a mother pastor, know the word of God. Don't just read the word of God when you're going to church on Sunday, on a Wednesday when you're going to a home cell or to a prayer meeting, or when they are requesting you to come and share the word of God. You need to know the scriptures that speaks of healing. I'm just giving an example. You need to know the scriptures that speaks of depression. You need to know the scriptures that speaks of single women. You need to know the scriptures that speaks about you as an individual. There are so many scriptures that speaks of different race, different culture. You know, the people who were building that thing where God came and destroyed and gave different languages. So what am I saying? You need to know how to treat the Gentiles, people with different languages. How do you react? How do you respond as a mother pastor? So what am I saying? You need to know the word of God. The Bible says, this book of the law must not depart from your lips. Whatever that I've spoken today, it's nothing more but the word of God. When you listen to all my videos, my DVD, if you have not listened, go and check one by one. I don't speak my own things there. I speak the word. The word is the only thing that is guiding me. Why? Because the word of God is full of knowledge, is full of wisdom. People will say, how do you know about divorce if you've never been divorced? God teaches me. The Holy Spirit teaches me. When I read about Vashti, she was divorced. I get to learn. I get to speak about it. I get to know how she felt. I get to understand how the king felt when he divorced his wife. The Bible says he longed for her. You know, he missed her. Why? Because that's when we are reading what? The scriptures. So how do you deal with rejection from family members? I go there, I check Joseph. Joseph was rejected by his family members. His brother, his son brother sold him. So what am I saying? There are a lot of answers. You will have an answer for everything because the Bible answers all. It has got all the information that is required for you to know. How do you know if a man loves you or not? The Bible will tell you. There are scriptures there written for you to know. Then who's the originator of marriage? It will tell you it's God. So what am I saying? What does God say about divorce? Why? How? When do you have the right to divorce? It will tell you even back there it was there. Someone will write a letter. You know, there are a lot of information in the Bible, even legally. So the Bible will teach you of things there, important information that you need to know. God will teach you about forgiveness. God will teach you even the things that I did not mention. So what am I saying? The word of God carries the full information of what you need. It is the guideline before you can listen to anybody on TV. People that are speaking on TV that we love, we admire speaking of God, they studied the word. The word, you are studying it for your own growth, for your own benefit. And don't forget to ask the Holy Spirit to guide you as you study the word of God. Teach him, tell him that Holy Spirit, teach me to love the word of God. Teach me to have the desire to study the Holy Spirit. It's not easy. When you read the Bible, sometimes when it's late at night, you even fall asleep. And then you find that sometimes they just come and take the Bible on top of your chest. Why? Because it's not an easy book. Hallelujah. It's not an easy book. But when you read the magazine, you find, 1 hour, 2 hours. Why? Because it's not the same. The entertainment you get from there is not the same as the benefit that you get for the Spirit. But I love you with the love of the Lord. As the mother pastor, please read the word of God. Know it with all your heart. I love you, and I wish you all the best.